I feel your pain. Sometimes it seems like we're just too busy to exercise. I get it. That's why I'm a big fan of taking multiple exercises and combining them into one to make the most out of my time. Today I'm going to teach you one of my favorite combined exercises, and we call it the Hippo Yawn. Now the Hippo Yawn is kind of like weight training. You can use weights, but you don't have to. Sometimes I like to use a little dumbbell. Sometimes I like to use a big dumbbell. And sometimes I'm the dumbbell and I don't use any weights at all. The choice is up to you. Now, the Hippo Yawn is part sumo squat, part bicep curl. Nothing to it. Let's talk about the upper body first, all right? First, we're going to take our biceps, engage them, flex them up. Now, do you need a weight? No. In that case, like you're holding a tray, and really engage those biceps. When we come up, we're just going to do a little curl. That's all. We're just going to do a little curl. Now, when it comes to the curl portion of the workout, I don't really care whether you use a big weight, a little weight, or no weight at all. Just concentrate on your bicep. You're going to really want to flex that muscle, engage that muscle, boom, engage that other muscle. Think of these guys. Those are the tusks, the hippo teeth, and when we yawn, we bring them up. We really have some resistance there. And push them down, and up, we're yawning. That's it. As long as these muscles are engaged, your heart rate is going to elevate. You add to that your quads and your glutes from the big sumo squat, and bam, your heart rate goes from 0 to 60 in a matter of seconds. Now the squat portion is simply a squat. Knees out, feet out, kind of wide. Get your good wide base. Try to put the weight into your heels, into the back. And just go down as deep as you can go. If this is as far as you can go, fine. This is as far as you can go. Try to keep that back straight and just sink down. Nice wide squat. Quads on fire. All right, so let's put it all together. For this demonstration, I'm going to go ahead and use my little 5-pound dumbbells. Why? Because, you know, hey, I'm a 5-pound dumbbell. So, we're going to take our feet, and we're going to go a little wider than the mat. We're going to go a little wider than hip distance, and we're going to turn those feet and those knees out. We're going to get a big, deep sumo squat. We're going to work our way down. If it's early in the morning, you might want to grease it up a little bit. Work your way down into a nice, deep squat. These guys, straight out, engaged, muscles engaged, and come up for 3, 2, 1, lower, 3, 2, 1. Engage your biceps the entire time. 3, 2, 1, lower, 3, 2, 1. That is a hippo yawn. The hippo yawn is a great combination of a sumo squat and a bicep curl. Two great exercises combined into one. It's like the Reese's peanut butter cup of fitness. So give it a try. Work it out yourself. My heart rate is pounding and we've just done a couple. Now I know some of you have a very limited amount of time to work out. Well, here is a great workout that you can do in 5 minutes. All right, here we are. So you say you don't have any time to work out. Well, here is a 5-minute workout. We're going to incorporate our hippo yawns that we just learned how to do into this workout. And in 5 minutes, we're going to work really, really, really hard to burn some calories, burn some fat, and get that heart rate up. We only have 5 minutes, so let's get this sucker going. We can't waste any time, so we're going to engage right away, bend slightly at the knees. Those suckers good and tight. Squeeze them together as you come up. Glutes tucked in nice and tight. Reach back there and smack them. Reach out. Grab the ball. Bang! Let that sucker spread those fingers wide. Take it up into touchdown. And slowly, as we exhale, come down. Hands down. We are not going to mess around. Right back up. Use that resistance like you're going through oatmeal. One more time. Just kind of get some length on the spine. Third time. Up into touchdown, and we're gonna huddle it up. Right here, hands on thighs, bent like a bar back. Let's get some length. Reach out above your head, grab that ball. Exhale, fall forward.
Inhale, back into bent-legged bar back. Hands to the mat, step or pop back. We can't mess around, we only have a few minutes. Let's go down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down again, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. To the mat, hands flat, feet flat, glutes loose. Up into a cobra. Curl your toes, butt in the air, down dog. Bend slightly at the knees, step or pop to the front of your mat. Now here we're going to incorporate our first hippo yawn. If you want to use a weight, I have them out here for you. If not, don't bother. Use your own dynamic resistance. I'm going to grab them. And I'm going to take them out and hold them firm. Really flexing those biceps while I'm here in the squatted position. And I'm going to come up for 3, 2, 1. Down, 3, 2, 1. Up, 3, 2, 1. I'm going to spread a little bit more. Down, 3, 2, 1. Up, 2, 1. Down, 3, 2, 1. Two more. 3, 2, 1. Down, 3, 2, 1. One more. 3, 2, 1. Down, 3, 2, 1. Take the weights out. Roll forward. Reach up, grab the ball. Come up for 3, 2, 1. Hold the squat. We're just going to hold it. And hold it. Oh, your quads are on fire. Hold it. Hold it. Toes and knees forward. Ball forward. Come up. One vertebrae at a time. Reaching up. Into a touchdown. Bringing it down. Push them together. We're headed to our first diamond cutter. Take it back. Out to a T. Clench your fists. Poke it up for 3, 2, 1. Tension. Chest out, shoulders back. Shake it off. But we're not going to shake it off. Slightly. Bring in the knees. Pull them forward. Pull them, squeeze them together. Glutes tight. Quads tight. Everything's tight. Heart rate through the roof. Boom. Grab it. Bring it down. Huddle up. Hands on thighs. Bent legged bar back. Reach above your head. Grab the ball. Exhale. Fall forward. Inhale. Back up to a bent legged bar back. Guess where we're going? One more time. Hands to the mat. Step or pop back. And down. 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're just going to hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All the way down. Hands flat, feet flat. Cobra. Curl your toes, butt in the air, down dog. Slightly at the knees. Step or hop to the front of your mat. One more time. Grab them. Make your tusks. And come up and curl. 3, 2, 1. Really get a good sumo squat here. Going down. 3, 2, 1. Up. 3, 2, 1. Down. 3, 2, 1. Concentrate on your biceps. 3, 2, 1. Down. 3, 2, 1. Two more. 3, 2, 1. Down. 3, 2, 1. One more. 3, 2, 1. Down. 3, 2, 1. Quads on fire. Get rid of them. Roll forward. Grab the ball. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Toes and knees forward. Fall forward. Roll it out. Woo. One vertebra at a time. Touchdown. Bring it down. Two diamond cutters to finish the sucker off. Pull it back. Out to a T. Oh, get up. Tension. One more time up. To a touchdown. Pull it down. Push against the resistance. Back, out, fists, Hulk, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, tension, chest out, shoulders back, shake it out. Alright, we're just going to wind it down now. Nice and easy, into a touchdown, fall forward. Bring it up one vertebrae at a time, back to a touchdown, fall forward again. Third one. Fall forward again. Come back up. Shake it out.